heart of your teams. The heart of Tennessee. Valley Sports South and Valley Sports Southeast. The heart of the fan.
The Predators played their cards right in Vegas on Tuesday, knocking off the first-place Golden Knights in a thriller. Tonight, it's on to L.A. to face the Kings, next on Bally Sports. Nashville Predators hockey on Bally Sports is brought to you by your Middle Tennessee Toyota dealers. From Crypto.com Arena in Los Angeles, California, we're getting set for some late-night NHL hockey. Tonight, the Nashville Predators are on the road to take on the Los Angeles Kings. Hey, don't look now, but take a look at who's on top of the Central Division at the moment. Yes, it is the Nashville Predators. And a big pack of teams in pursuit. A very, very deep division as we get closer to the halfway point. Hi, everybody. Willie Donick along with Hal Gill. Back home, we want to salute our man Chris Mason, who will be back with us here very shortly. And Lindsey Rowley will be along throughout the evening. And Hal, the Predators have now won two straight, including the opener on this road trip. They knew Vegas would be tough, but they had a difference maker named Philip Forsberg.
Yeah, I felt like after that Chicago win, they got the win, but it wasn't their prettiest game. They came back against Vegas, had a really strong performance, and you got a beautiful highlight reel goal from Philip Forsberg, doing the dirty work too, blocking a shot here, assessing the situation. He's got pretty good defenseman in Pietrangelo. He doesn't have any other options, so he's going to take it to the net. Little flip of the puck, embarrasses Pietrangelo. He doesn't like that too much, but watch this. Hand-eye power, setting his edges, bringing it back to the backhand for a silky finish. That's something special from Phil Forsberg, and he had a huge game, a goal before that as well.
And then it was a 3-0 game down the stretch, and then Vegas came on strong, but UC Saros was ready to go.
He was fantastic. They got a penalty kill before this, and then it was an all-out battle to finish this game. Vegas threw everything they could at the net, and Saros was up to task. He was fantastic the whole game, making big saves, fighting through traffic, bobbing and weaving, trying to look around all these guys packed in front of him, making saves, kicking out the pads. The boys love the juice.
Our first Middle Tennessee Toyota starting goalie is UC Saros. He'll be in there again today. 7-3-1 in his last 11 on the road, and a season-high 41 saves in the game at Vegas. Meanwhile, the LA Kings are a team in transition. They've gone through a full rebuild. They've still got a lot of youngsters that are just starting to scratch the surface for them. So they've got some key veterans that they've added, including a guy we know very well, our Hyundai player to watch. Yes, the familiar face of Victor Arvidsson.
RV Hustle. Yeah, you know what you're going to get out of him. Heavy on the floor check. He's playing well for this team. He's driving the net. He's making things happen for him. And it's nice to see Arvy come out here, have some success. We all appreciate what he did with the Preds. Hopefully they can find a way to stop him. But you know you're going to see the jump screen. You know you're going to see heavy forecheck in and around the net. Arvy plays a hard brand of hockey, and Preds have to be aware of him everywhere he is.
Four-point game in their last game against the Philadelphia Flyers. They've also got still some holdovers with a great championship team. You love Anze Kopitar.
Yeah, Hall of Fame stats right there. This guy can play a couple Selkies under his belts for the best defensive forward in the game. He's something special.
And our other Middle Tennessee Toyota starting goalie, another holdover from the championship years, a resurgent Jonathan Quick. Look at his numbers in his last two starts, and his whole season has been very, very strong. These two teams met back in Nashville in October. And yes, Tanner Janot exerted his will against the Kings on that night, introducing himself to Drew Doughty and company. It's the Predators and the Kings coming up next. Nashville Selector, the predictor game that offers serious prize potential. Scan the QR code that you see on the screen or visit your Preds app and make your predictions ahead of every Preds home game for your chance to win signed merchandise, tickets to games, and VIP suite experiences. Nashville Predators Hockey is brought to you by your Mid-South Ford dealer and by Zaxby's, featuring fresh-made chicken tenders, wings, and salads. Crypto.com Arena is the site for this evening matchup in Los Angeles, California. Warm and sunny here, not so warm and very snowy back home, but we're glad all of you are up late watching with us tonight. Hey, what do you got to do? A lot of you are snowed in tomorrow anyway, so grab a little cup of coffee and enjoy this one. Willie Donacal, Gill, and Lindsey Rowley. Hal, let's give them the Mid-South Ford keys to the game.
Yeah, it's good to be the king. And the Preds, I'm not talking about the L.A. Kings. I'm talking about the Preds, the king of the Central Division. And they've come out and earned that. But someone's going to try to knock the king off. So you got to be ready to go every night. And the other one is in honor of Jim Morrison, Mr. Mojo Rising. The Preds got their mojo going, and they need to keep it going tonight.
Here is your Zaxby's opening puck drop, and away we go. The Predators starting off the herd once again. Here's Blake Lizotte working in. That's Brendan Lemieux sending that one wide of the net. Puck picked up by Arthur Kaliev. For the fourth line, starting out for the Kings. Working down low is Alex Carrier with Roman Josi. Those two paired together for a third straight game as Dante Fabro remains on the COVID list. No changes to the lineup. Nashville coming off the win in Vegas. Here's a centering pass off of the back of the cage. It popped up in the air, and then it was whacked out of there by Colton Sissy. Finally, Nashville gets out of their own end after about 40 seconds. And they ice the puck, so they'll have to stay out there.
Yeah, not the start that the Preds wanted. That's a young fourth line for the Kings that's going to come out. They're going to, you got to expect that every time they're on the ice. They're going to work hard. They're going to attack the net. Brendan Lemieux is going to try to get under your skin. So that herd line has got their hands cut, their hands full with these guys out there.
A shot is blocked off the faceoff. Nashville would like to get a line change here. Top line out there, Andrei Kopitar, his first touch of the puck. Centering pass off to the circle. That one turned away by Juuse Saros. Adrian Kempe fired that shot along with Martin Furk on the top line tonight. Martin Furk making his season debut. Here comes Kopitar. His centering pass deflected and then cleared by Josi, but right back to Kopitar. Now Drew Doughty takes over. Diagonal feed. They try to crisscross. Doughty gets it back in the bottom of the circle. Nashville can't get out of their own end. Finally, Yakov Kernan will skate it to center, and the Predators can get a line change.
Yeah, they needed that change, didn't they? They get the big line out there after they've been tired after a long shift.
But cleared down the ice, and now it'll be icing on the Kings. That'll give us a chance to give you the Vanderbilt Health player update. Same lineup as we mentioned. Phil Tomasino rotates out for a second straight game as a healthy scratch. Dante Fabro still on the COVID list. Should be back fairly shortly. Tommy Novak, by the way, sent on a conditioning assignment to Milwaukee to play for the Admirals. He's coming off of the COVID list. We'll see Ryan Johansson take this draw with Eli Tolvanen and Luke Kunin. Face off one, Doughty off to Kempe. Wiping out was Victor Arvidsson. Arvidsson spinning around on his backside, trying to advance the puck. Now he gets back up, he's got it. Now he's knocked right back down by Luke Kunin. Well, there's Victor Arvidsson in a nutshell. Gets knocked down, gets back up quickly.
He'll keep going.
He will. Energizer Bunny, we know him well. 4 points in the last game. There's a shot by Philip Deneau, clubbed down by Juuse Saros. The Kings coming out fresh. They haven't played since New Year's Day.
Yeah, Arvy going down the boards. He got knocked down and stayed with it and took another hit. This play, a little bump off the boards. You got a good gap from Myers. Ekholm comes over and forces a wide shot. Not a problem for Juuse. Makes a nice, easy glove save.
The Kings won 6-3 against the Flyers on New Year's Day. They've had 4 days off since then. Victor Arvidsson scored 12 seconds into that game. So they came out of the gate fast. Arvidsson, 2 goals and 2 assists in that one.
They're doing the same thing right now.
There's Phil Myers getting his third consecutive start, having a little trouble. It comes out to the bottom of the circle. Arvidsson sweeps it to the boards. He's pinned there by Myers. Skating up the ice now is Philip Forsberg. Forsberg whips it cross ice for Mikhail Granlund. Now Matt Duchene, third man on that top line out there. Behind the net, Forsberg turns to his forehand. Tries to get the shot away, and a late whistle, and he's able to find that puck.
A nice move there from Forsberg. Pulling it forehand and dragging it across. That's really hard to defend. First of all, good work in the corner, digging to find that puck. And you can see how Forsberg protects the puck and brings it to the net, just trying to get it into a position where you could get it on the forehand. Quick was right on top of him, so he's unable to get it up and in. Took a hit. He doesn't mind. He'll get right back up.
Granlund stays on to take the faceoff against Kopitar. The Kings are an excellent faceoff team. It all starts with number 11. He'll take a ton of them.
Big and strong in the circle.
Faceoff one back. Drew Doughty takes it. Doughty played in the first game between these two teams way back on October the 19th. Then he spent a long time on the injured list, but he's had a very productive year so far when he's been in there. Here's Forsberg trying to get loose. Kempe beats Duchene to the puck, puts it off the sideboards. Here's Josi activating, tries to make the move around Doughty, gets tangled with him, keeps the possession moving. Carrier at the line for Granlund, now to a cutting Forsberg. Drop pass to Carrier. Carrier down the slot, all the way in, and he's stopped by Quick. A great save. Penalty call coming up. Outstanding skating by Carrier.
Unreal play from Carrier. That's a power move. Throw in some skill there. Let's see how they're going to call this. Good movement, Roman Josi.
Los Angeles number 11, minor penalty holding.
Oh, I don't know if that was much of a call there. I'm not sure if I'm seeing the same thing they're seeing. But a good power move protects the puck, gets it towards the net, and then tries to look like Bobby Orr. That would have been nice if it went in.
Los Angeles penalty to number 11, Andre Kopitar.
2 minutes. So Kopitar will go to the box, and Nashville will go on the power play for the first time tonight. They only had one power play two nights ago against Vegas. They went 0-for-1. Power play's been a strong force all season long, really, particularly on the road. Cunning will take the draw, so the Predators will start the second unit out. Carrier and Ekholm, two defensemen on this unit. Cunning, Cousins, and Tolvanen. Philip Deneau, picked up in the offseason as a free agent, is out there. There's a lot of the dirty work. Down low, Carrier working with Cousins. Carrier again, right out to the net front. So Carrier spending a lot of time where a power forward
been
would
busy,
spin.
Yeah. I like that. I feel like, especially when you have a guy like Ekholm back there, you can take that chance, be a little more aggressive than you usually would.
Carrier goes off. Roman Josi goes on. They go give and go to the captain. Josi trying to find Ekholm at the point. Josi now on the half wall. A spinning pass anticipated well by the Kings and clear.
The Kings shrinking the zone well, surrounding and taking away time and space, making those little plays hard.
Josi, an up key to Duchene. Drop back, Josi, pressured, swings it to the other side. Forsberg has time. Closes in, snaps it, he scores! Philip Forsberg stays red hot, and he gives the Predators a 1-0 lead, his third goal in the last two games.
Well, talk about making something out of nothing. Phil Forsberg just, hey, if you're going to give me a little time and space off the half wall, I might as well just roof it. It's an easy game, eh, Phil? Just come in off the dot and smoke it. Not a chance in the world for Quick. What a beautiful shot that was. And, you know, that pulls the penalty kill out. Next power play you get, they're going to have to be aggressive on that.
Hermitage Design Center, first goal of the game, authored by Philip Forsberg. That is number 18. That is number 17 in the last 21 games alone. You talk about a streak.
And we talked about him trying to catch up with David Legwand.
He's closing that gap fast.
I mean, with a shot like that, it's kind of inevitable, I think.
Nick Cousins jumps on a loose puck. So the Predators get the power play cashed in. Cousins twirls to the net. Stick goes flying, belonging to an LA Kings player. Nashville keeps it going. Matt Luff is down there playing in his second straight game. He played a lot of games here for the Kings. Kings let him go. So you know he'd like to do well tonight. Luff behind the net, battling for it. Luff staying after it. Michael McCarron out there with him. It's chipped off the glass and down the ice. King's in a change. Staying out there is Myers to tip it in. Now he'll go off, and here comes the Herd. Trennan will shadow. That's Tobias Bjornfoot. I beg your pardon. That is Matt Roy, who put it down the ice. It ends up behind Saras. Blake Lizotte. Speeding. Get it to the point. Shot it through. That changed direction. Followed by Saras on an in-between hop. That one got past the man. Jacob Movarare playing in his first NHL game. That's number 57. He'll work with Roy. Now blasting up the ice, Arthur Callier. Drops it off. Lizotte. He hit the post, and it goes out of play. That fourth line wasn't all over the place. They're going to be the first line before it's all over.
Yeah, that's a pretty nice move. Kaliev, a young player that they're really high on here. He's part of that youthful movement. Lizotte as well. Just a little drop pass. Attack the middle and get the shot off, right off the bar. Yeah, be careful of those ones. Tanner Jeannot, that's a tough one. You either got to block it or you got to get it out of the way. You don't want to tip it. That was a tough one. Skipping in on Saros. Still made the save.
Another faceoff win for L.A. Dowdy tried to shoot it through the traffic. It got through. Stayed along the ice. Jeannot retrieves. Jeannot powers his way. A backhander, that hit the post. And Saros is able to cover. That was almost an impossible angle, but that's two pipes.
Yeah, I think they're just, the idea is get pucks to the net and attack. This Kings team is playing a direct line game. Nice move from Jeannot. Brings it to the backhand. Now he's just trying to get it in there, get an ugly one.
So Philip Deneau, instrumental on that run by the Montreal Canadiens all the way to the Stanley Cup final. Earned himself a nice contract for the Kings. Faceoff is loose. Everybody tied up, and the Predators are going to go on the penalty kill here. Holding the stick, I believe. Holding something. So the Predators cash in with Forsberg from Josi and Granlund on their power plate. And now it'll be the Kings' turn.
Nashville number 45, 2 minutes for holding the stick.
Well, the Preds' penalty kill has been so good. They don't want to keep pushing it, though. This one, you know, you're battling in to find it. Faceoffs are so important. You want to help out. You want to get in there and help out Granlund win that one. And I think he just clamped down and fought a little bit too hard.
Kings have had one, six out of the first eight faceoffs. Nashville wins that one and clears. The Kings on the power play, 1-for-3 in their win over Philadelphia. That broke a five-game drought, so they'll feel a little bit better about things. Here comes Kempe, full sweep across the line. Quick puck movement to Doughty to the side first. Doughty, a quick reversal, one-timer coming. Save made. Kopitar gets his own rebound, kicked out to him. He tries to go through the box. It was deflected and cleared by Bennett.
Well, that's a shot. The Kopitar, I think Saros knows that it's going to come there. It's predictable. He can get out there. He can challenge it. They're willing to give that one up.
Kempe carrying the mail again. Works it to Arvidsson. Arvidsson sets it up to Doughty. Kopitar behind the net. Arvidsson looks to swing it. They pressure him. Quirk to the middle. Doughty a diving play to keep it inside the blue line. Good effort. Kopitar. Sliding down low, works it back out high. Furt tees it up and fires. That was blocked by Myers. Retrieval, Arvidsson. Arvidsson cuts to the net. Kopitar feeds it to the point again. Now Doughty working again with Kopitar. Kopitar to the net front, saved by Saros. Rebound, stopped. Furt gets the rebound, didn't pull the trigger. Kopitar to Doughty for the one-timer. That hit the post. Kopitar sent it wide, and it'll go down the ice. Three iron hits in the first period for the Kings.
You see Saros. You see Saros' two best friends, both posts. That's just good angles. I think Juice had good angles, that's all.
Would that be the three best friends that anybody ever had, the yes. Crossbar and the two posts?
You got that right.
Nashville breathing a sigh of relief, but back come the Kings again. Here's the shot by Kaliev. That's popped up in the air. All kinds of heat. On the Predators' penalty kill, out of the box comes Carrier. Nashville kills it off barely. Kaliev again. Dumps it in. His man pulled up, though. That was Dustin Brown. He'll circle off. So Nashville survives 8 minutes in with a 1-0 lead. Now Cunning gets around the defender. Centers it! And a great play. Johansson almost tucked it in from a tough angle.
That looks like he got it up and over, just he couldn't find a way to get it in.
Terrier fired one that was blocked. Cunning jumps on the loose puck. Terrier works his way down the wall and is erased by Lemieux. Tolvanen comes back. This one kept in at the line. Johansson looking for Cunning down in the low slot. And a one-timer, a drive by Tolvanen. That was a laser beam. Stopped by Jonathan Quick. Now Lemieux getting delivered a message by Ryan Johansson. Crazy start to this game.
A couple little jabs in there.
Orange Bar in the Rooms to Go Lounge. The Predators continue their Western swing tonight in L.A. They knocked off the Kings 2-1 in Nashville earlier this season. Another positive for the Preds tonight. They're 21-12-6 all time in the City of Angels.
That was way back on October the 19th. That was the Predators' first win of the year. If you recall, Hal, they lost the first two games. They had a four-game homestand, then eked out a tough 2-1 win against L.A.
Seems like forever ago, doesn't it?
Yeah, it
does. You lose a couple games and you say, uh-oh, this isn't going to be good. Well, look where we are now.
The Predators started 0-2, then they were 1-4, and now they've climbed to the top of the Central. Forsberg's 18th from Josi and Granlund at 3:49. But L.A. has had all kinds of traffic and chances to start this game.
That power play, they had some beauty chances. It looked like a pretty good penalty kill. It's just a couple miscues on the clears that cost them. Juice came up big, and then he got a little help from his friends.
16 shot attempts already. Here's Forsberg again. The slot for Granlund, broken up. Dowdy, a one-hand pass, looking for Burke. Now they'll try the other side with Kempe. Kempe to the net front. That's tipped high by Furk. Furk, a guy that's been a dominating AHL scorer, getting a chance to play on the first line tonight. Activated from the taxi squad. This one gets past Carrier. A race for the puck as Dustin Brown closes in. Dustin Brown will deliver the lumber. He loves to hit. Brown looking for his hand at the blue line. Carrier absorbed the hit, got back in the play, broke it up.
Yeah, Dustin Brown. I played with him in the World Championships a long time ago. A young kid coming in. What a great career he's had. When you say he hits through you. He'll go right through your sternum. You'll know when he's out there.
Michael McCarron getting physical. Predators had 55 hits. That's the most they've ever had in a game since they started keeping track of the hits.
Who is keeping track?
Well, they were liberal with it for sure, but it was a physical game.
It was a lot of bangs out there.
That one tipped on net by Cousins. Good save by Quick. Here's Brown, now up over 1,240 games in his career. Matias Ekholm working with Matt Benning again. He talked to Matt Benning about that. He can play with just about anybody, but this year he's really been solid with Mark Borowiecki.
Yeah, they've been, you know, that was a question before the season. They shored that up. They took that spot and run with it. Physical, hard, killing penalties. It's a good deep pair with both of those guys. When you get a healthy lineup with Favreau back in.
Loose puck. Johansson has to wait for Luke Cunningham to tag up. He does. Now puts it into the corner. Here comes Ellie Tolvanen. Gets a good hit, followed up by Cunningham's hit. Lazat survives it, skates it ahead. He's cut off by Tolvanen. This one, poke check to the line by Borowiecki. He throws a little shoulder into Lemieux.
I kind of like seeing Ellie go out there and throw the body. Hey, he just goes full send.
I'm going to show you how well the Predators are on the hit category. Speaking of that, here comes Chenault and Sisson. Nashville number one on the road in hits. Now on the counter, here come the Kings. Deneau looks to center, gets around Myers. Deneau beats him in the corner. Now on the opposite side, Anderson with Arvidsson. Arvidsson on the backhand, turns, shoots, juggled by Saros, but he has it. Nashville picking up where they left off in the check department. Hello, Ellie Tolvanen.
Boom.
Two blast deep. Welcome back. Preds leading the Kings 1-0 in the first period. Preds coming off the big win in Vegas. Philip Forsberg had two goals in that game, and Phil already has another goal tonight. The third period in Vegas got pretty heated. Michael McCarron and Tanner Janot both calling out the Vegas bench, standing up for their team. I spoke with Philip Forsberg after the game and asked him what the vibe is like on the bench, on the ice, when you have guys like that standing up, sending a message, and he said, it's great. We've clearly established ourselves as a physical team in this league, and it's great to know that guys like that are going to answer the bell at any moment. And Phil said, yeah, those other teams, they can yap all they want. Guys?
All right, Lindsay, thanks a lot. We certainly don't mind the altercation, and already the table's being set tonight with that. Here's Mikey Anderson, his shot into sticks, and again, Saros able to follow the puck. Martin Furk got a little piece of that. Let's hear from Rooms to Go.
Go style, go savings, go selection. At Rooms to Go, you can go any way you want, by the piece or by the room, and always make the most of your space for less. Rooms to Go. Let's go.
I love hearing that you know, Phil is rooting for those guys. Going chirping at the bench, says, hey, jump over the boards, let's go. And, you know, even the skill players get in on that. They have some fun with it, too. A team mentality. And that's where they're having the fun with it.
Kempe getting the business down low to Carrier. He's able to work it up to Luff, though. Luff arches it. Cousins will chase it against one of the young defenders, Sean Durzer. They really like him. They picked him up in the Jake Muzzin trade a couple years ago with Toronto. A couple of interesting trades with the Maple Leafs between these two teams.
Yeah, they are high on him. They have high hopes for that kid.
Yossi lost his balance at the line. He almost got toppled over by McCarron, who did a good job of dodging him. Here's a rebound cleared by Yossi up the boards, and Luff chips it out. Kings take it back. Kings at 16-12-5 in a pack of teams just below the playoff line right now. Very deep group of teams in the Western Conference. A lot of them have played different teams. There's Philip Forsberg. He's got the puck, but he doesn't have a stick. He tried to do his best soccer imitation to advance it as long as he could.
That's tough to do with your head down. It's a dangerous league when you skate around with your head down.
Brandlin tried the quick outlet pass. Hit a skate, came right back to him. Kings tag up quickly. Matthew Shane finds himself with the puck. He'll make the pivot, buy some time. Ekholm tries to drive it in deep using the sideboards. 13 minutes have gone by here in this first period in L.A. Building renamed Crypto.com Arena. Still got to get used to that.
That's a little different. Hard not to say Staples.
Certainly a busy place. Bouncing puck handled by Saros as that one was hit out of midair. Saros has faced every type of shot in this first period. Johansson trying to gain the red line. Everybody colliding and crisscrossing. LA takes it back. Here's Doughty. He'll be out there for about half the game. He does not get tired. 32 years of age now. A battle in the corner for Vietzky. Able to get a shoulder on it. Myers, a long outlet pass, bouncing just out of the reach of Sissons, but he'll get there first. Tobias Bjornfoot is on it. Now Janot joins in. On the cycle, Trennan down there, the third man. Sissons can't hang on to his stick. And the Kings take possession. Yossi down the boards. Yossi looks for a loose puck. Trennan had it pried loose for a moment. Sissons got to hustle to tag back up. Shots are 12-4 in favor of the Kings. Predators have 12 hits already in the contest. Here's an errant pass. McCarron skates over and disjointed the play. Luff from the Kings bench. He's acquainted with some of those guys. Sent it down the boards. Now the Predators are trying to slow the pace down a little bit.
Yeah,
the Kings have taken the game to them.
Yeah, they have. So it's good, though. They've got to move zones and make them go 200 feet.
Offside is the call. 5:15 to play in the first period. Philip Forsberg's 18th, an early goal. Different Predators so far in the first period. They lead it 1-0. Speaking of physicality, How would you be surprised to know that if you take players that play, you know, regularly, 250 minutes more at 5-on-5, the Predators have four of the top 36 hitters in the entire league.
Yeah, they're spreading it out. Borowiecki, he closes gap faster than most D in the league, and that's how he gets those big hits. The rest of it is just crashing and banging on the forecheck. Tanner Jeannot, Luke Cunning, they're going to give you everything they got.
And one thing to keep in mind, too, that different buildings kind of look at the stat differently. Some dish it out a little bit more, like we saw in Vegas. And the Predators building actually is a little more stringent in what they consider a hit. So there is a little bit of subjectivity there.
Room for interpretation, right?
But so you could argue that, you know, they could even have more.
Yeah.
Here comes Josi. Tried to toe drag around a man. Puck retrieved by Granlund. Gets out of the way of a check. Sends it down low. Quick stops it. And brings it back around for Kopitar. Puck cleared by Kempe. Josi comes over quickly. Starts the attack back again. 4.5 minutes to go in this first period. Philip Forsberg, a power play goal to give the Predators the advantage. Long outlet pass out of the reach of Deneau, and this will go for icing. Let's look at the DraftKings Sportsbook. Follow the money. Remember last night, the Predators were only at 27% of the bets on the money line. Tonight, a little more attention, 91%. But you never know with these things. That's why you play the games.
Hey, that's why they call it a gamble, you know?
That's right.
Well, the Preds have been earning their money. They've been playing pretty hard and winning games, so they get that respect.
Face off one back to Doughty. Arvidsson along the boards. Gave way to Johansson. Johansson just missed the referee with the dump in. Mikey Anderson, the up feed to Trevor Moore. Couldn't hang on. It bounces past Kump. Nashville starts the forecheck again. Tolvanen tried to jump the passing lane. Couldn't quite get there, but he did deflect it. That negates the icing.
Yeah, I think this game has slowed down at the pace that started it out, and I think that's a good thing for the Preds. Kings were buzzing.
John Hines talking about how he wanted his team to throw their game since the Christmas break, try to build it back. They were in such a groove before play was halted. Came back, had a loss and an overtime loss, then two wins.
Yeah, they got their mojo back. I think that Vegas game, a little confidence from that one.
That was a big confidence boost. That's a tough place to win. Good battle for the puck. Trenin had it caught and escaped. Meanwhile, behind the play, we've got Borowiecki and Lemieux. A lot of chirping between those two.
Just pounding each other in the chest.
And we know Lemieux, the lineage of that name for sure. And then Lemieux, of course, has been in the middle of a bunch of stuff this year.
Claude Lemieux, one of the best rats in the game.
One way of putting it. Here's the other answer. Anderson, that's Elias Anderson wearing number 17. This one ends up back in the middle. Patrolling there was Cousins. He'll go deep for McCarron. Followed up Luff. His shot stopped by Quick and the rebound bouncing through the slot. Matt Luff letting it go.
He's got a great shot, doesn't he? You've seen that. You know, he hasn't had too many shots, but when he lets it go, it comes off hot.
There's Josi with that inside pivot move that's so dangerous. Got it down low for Cousins. Cousins pinned into the boards. Trying to work it free is Rasmus Kupari. Bjornfoot along the half wall. Nashville still fighting to keep the possession alive. Luff is down there. Luff had a year where he had 8 goals in only 33 games for the Kings. It looked like he was on his way, but a couple years later, he sort of got lost in the numbers game.
Nashville was glad to get him. You can see his speed.
There's McCarron getting a tip. He had his first goal here recently. Tipped it out of play. Well, Hal, you got the Arizona Coyotes coming up on Saturday. That'll round out this road trip. And then it'll be the rubber match on Tuesday
with
the Avalanche coming to town.
This is going to be a good one. Preds got to take care of business. We got a couple games here on the road before you go back home. And, you know, if you want to win this division, you're going to have to beat Colorado. And talk about an exciting team to watch.
Oh, man.
Nathan MacKinnon, if you've never seen him in person, you definitely should get the Bridgestone because he's fun to watch.
Tickets still available for that one. Just go to NashvillePredators.com. You're going to want to see that one. The last time the two teams played, remember, both were devastated by the COVID wave.
That's right.
So they'll both be more closer to full strength, it would appear, when they go head-to-head on Tuesday.
Yeah, that'll be a great game.
Kempe driving it ahead. Turning the corner! Kempe, everybody crashing in! Penalty call coming up.
That's got to be on Kempe, I would imagine.
Soros went flying back. The net went flying.
Gone. Yeah, he had made no attempt whatsoever to stay away from Soros. Good, strong power move. We talked about him raising his game, and you can see it right there, setting his edges. Yeah, Benning, if Benning doesn't push him there, I think that's just him going straight in.
Number 9, 2 minutes, goal interference.
Well, Todd McClellan over on the bench for L.A., definitely arguing that Benning did push him in. He wants the attention of the officials. And now you can see Drew Doughty trying to get his 2 cents worth in to the official Trevor Hansen right at center ice.
Yeah, that's a tough spot for Benning. He's on the backside of Kempe, and that's a tough one. I think Kempe makes that effort. He's got to at least show that he's not going to try to run over the goalie. You know, that's.
There's Todd McClellan still heated up.
I think Benning gave him the out to go behind the net, and he didn't take it.
You've been in that situation many times, Hal. That's a tough one because you
don't
want to protect
your
goalie.
You want to protect him. You don't want to help the guy go over your goalie. It's a tough spot, but I think Benning played that right.
Well, the fans are giving it to him now as Soros stops that clear. Nashville's second chance on the power play. They cashed it in the first one. Johansson moves laterally. Stripped to the puck. Clearing attempt just over the shoulder of Forsberg. He's ducking for cover. He didn't know what to do. He thought he was going to maybe catch it, and then he figured, this one's going to hit me in the chin. Now Duchesne. All the way in! He scores! It got across the line! Matt Duchesne! Right up the middle.
Wow. Talk about playing downhill. That's the way Matt Duchesne can be effective, and that's exactly what he does. He looks like he's looking for a pass. Quick flick of the wrist. Gets it onto his forehand, and a quick release. Quick made that initial save, and then it just trickles in. Good power move from Matt Duchesne.
Matt Duchesne. Only his second goal in the last 14 games, so he's been due. And you look at this. Quick reaching back, but he couldn't quite get there in time after he got a piece of that initial shot. But that was quick hands.
Quick hands.
By Duchesne.
He's so dynamic. He's got a quick little shift on his body weight. Protects the puck, and nope, are we going to get one here?
Oh, we got some conversations going on right now between Lemieux and Janot. So Nashville 2-for-2 on the power play. So the power play, particularly on the road, continues to be a massive source of energy and production for the Predators this year.
Yeah, the full package right now, playing well 5-on-5, killing penalties, and the power play is getting it done.
Brennan. Just abusing Lazat behind the net. Lazat fell down. Trennan took full advantage. Now Trennan still working down low. Now Trennan's got it. He'll work it out to Benning. Benning. For Ekholm, he'll keep the cycle moving. Around the horn systems. By the centering feed towards Janot against the grain. Nashville content to just keep it right down low and grind away. Letting Janot and Trennan do their thing, and that'll do it for the first period.
Yeah,
so Nashville finishes with a serve.
They'd love 40 more minutes of grinding in the offensive zone.
So Forsberg and Duchesne, power play goals in the first period, and they'll head to the locker room up 2-0. Jack in the Box intermission is coming up. Lindsey Rowley will join us. We'll look ahead for what's coming up in Smashville with the Avalanche coming in on Tuesday, and we'll have some reports from down on the bench.
By Fifth Third Bank, member FDIC, and by Vanderbilt Health, exclusive healthcare provider of the Nashville Predators.
Power play goals from Forsberg and Duchesne in the first period as we get set to play period number 2. And while we have a second, we're going to give a shout out to the American military personnel serving overseas. They're watching this game on AFN, the American Forces Network. Welcome to those in countries around the world aboard naval ships at sea. And we want to thank you for your service. It's an honor to be bringing you this contest from Los Angeles.
Love you guys.
Willie Donick, Hal Gill,
out there.
And Lindsey Riley here with you in Los Angeles at Crypto.com Arena. The score a little bit deceiving. It reminds me a little bit of the Chicago game on New Year's Day, Hal, where statistically things favor the Kings with scoring chances 9-4, shot attempts 22-10, shots on goal 13-6. But Nashville opportunistic and making the most of their chances.
A couple beautiful goals.
So they certainly had plenty to discuss.
Yeah, they just got to play the right way. Hines has talked about it all year long. Play the right way, do the little things right, and you get rewarded for it.
There's Tanner Janot busting into the zone. Winds it around the board for Roman Josi. Josi, two assists in the first period. Both of the Predators' goals on the power play, as we mentioned. On the cycle, Josi working it down low. Josi to the middle. Sissons wide open in the slot. Fanned on the shot. Keeps possession, though. Looks for some help. Interchanging with Josi. Josi cutting to the net. Josi brings it all the way in. Stopped by Quinn. Sprawling down on the ice. Josi doing Josi things, Josi, is like you say.
Josi things. Great puck possession. Sissons ragging it down. He had a chance. Instead, he puts it over to Josi, and Josi setting his edge, attacking the post. Has a little opening to bring it across, and he just loses a handle right at the last second. His legs do a lot of the work. He doesn't have to stick handle much because he just one or two pushes, and he's past defenders left and right. Roman Josi doing Roman Josi things.
Jonathan Quick, a little bit unorthodox, right? This athleticism, pretty unique type of goalie. He's done it for so long.
He's fun to watch, though.
He really is.
He'll make things an adventure.
Open man coming at the net. It's Victor Arvidsson challenging Juuse Saros. Saros makes the save with the blocker. That was vintage Arvidsson that just busting up that wing.
Hard down the wing, let her rip.
Here he comes again. This time Benning is on it. Arvidsson lost the stick. A chance for Cunnan to clear. He's able to get it to Johansson. Coming back in L.A. There's Mo Varare. NHL debut, Trevor Moore chips it to the opposite corner. Arvidsson speeding there. Benning seals him. Man open in front. It was Moore. He directed it just wide. Johansson has some space. He'll flick it in. Here comes Forsberg. Forsberg with a goal and an assist. Another electrifying shot to get the scoring started.
93 miles per hour, that shot.
Backhander by Carrier. Popped up in the air, and then two Kings collide. Josi attacking from the opposite side. Now it's Forsberg again. His pass changed direction. Mikhail Granlund. Granlund swinging out high. Forsberg did a good job of avoiding Kopitar. Granlund to the net front. Knocked down. Well defended by the Kings. Kopitar re-engaged with Forsberg. Throws a shoulder into him. Furt to the line. Kempe. Saros has an open man. Bank pass for Granlund. Granlund towards the end of his shift. Hands it off to Nick Cutts. Oh. Well, he's been flying.
A little hit from the side there.
And McCarron widening up. Myers a drive. Pivot move, Duchesne. Still working out there. He's been out there for a good while. Couldn't hang on. Nice play by Borowiecki.
Aggressive gap, stays right up on it. Burrow's been good at that.
Centering pass, rebound, score! It's the former King, Matt Luff! His first goal is a Predator, and Nashville takes a 3-0 lead.
Going hard to the net, the kid gets his goal. That is nice. Just a simple play, get the puck in, drive wide, and then get it to the net. Nice backhand feed across from McCarron. And the finish from Luff. Coach brought him in the lineup because he's got that speed. He beats his guy to the back door. The initial save from Quick, and then the quick rebound. Squeeze it inside the post. A big goal for the Preds.
So Matt Luff chipping in. He fed Michael McCarron in Columbus for McCarron's first goal. And then McCarron returns the favor.
I got you, buddy. I'll get you right back.
So the fourth line coming through. Now Sissons again working wide open in the slot. Outlet pass to Dustin Brown. Brown stops, and Borowiecki seals him into the boards right as the whistle was blowing for offside. Let's hear from FanDuel Sportsbook.
Hey fans, right now you can live bet on the game on the FanDuel Sportsbook. Head over to FanDuel now.
So how Matt Luff was let go by Los Angeles. He's always been a very productive scorer in the AHL, but very under the radar. The Predators liked what they saw from him when they picked him up as a budget free agent. Look at everybody in the stands. Man, that thing came in hot.
Heads up. Yeah, no, that's it's funny because Hines has been trying to find a fourth line. He had Tomasino in there, a little more skill player. He brings Luffin, who's got a long, hard stride. He's got speed down the wing. And he can shoot. And he's going to the net playing hard. So you have McCarron, Cousins, and Luff all play a bigger game. I think we got an injury up there. There's some concern behind the bench.
I hope everybody's all right. That came in with no chance to react. Janot is able to dump this one in. So Matt Luff picks up his first as a Predator to get the assist. McCarron will certainly get one. Now Janot battling for it. He'll power his way to the net. Followed up by Sissons just wide.
Oh, boy.
Cold Sissons shoulder. Goes down hard.
The cold shoulder got Sissons.
Ekholm pinching in. LA having trouble in this period getting out of their own zone. Nashville has done a much better job 5-on-5 to start this period. If you joined us late, the Kings were all over the Predators early in the first period. They hit the post 3 times. But Nashville had a little puck luck, and now
that's not luck. Saros knew his angles.
That's right. So you're talking like Mace.
Yeah.
I gave you the post. Right? Yeah. I gave you that. That's what I gave you.
A little bit of luck never hurt.
Borowiecki pounded into the boards. Myers shovels it up the boards. Penalty call coming up. Moore looking back door for Arvidsson. Actually, no penalty call here. Here's the shot. Saros with the save. Rebound bounces off the backboard. I thought they had Arma.
He put his hand up because he thought Borowiecki broke Moore's stick. It wasn't. It was Borowiecki's stick that broke. So he pulled it back away.
Nashville again weathers a storm. 15-15 to play in the second period. Luck for McCarron and Cousins.
I should say, at least I think that's what he was thinking.
Duchesne powers his way in. This one blocked by Roy. All right, let's see this play again because there's still a piece of Borowiecki's stick on the ice.
Here. Yeah, so Borowiecki goes in, and I think he said, all right, that's a slash because it's a broken stick, and then he realizes that it was Borowiecki's stick that broke. I still think it should have been called a slash, right? But a good break for Borowiecki that it was his stick that broke and not. Yeah, in any event, refs can change your mind too, right? Realize he made a mistake and just put your arm back down.
Firk to Kempe. Kempe has a step on Carrier, slams on the brakes, and Carrier's going to commit a penalty, and it's a penalty shot. So Adrian Kempe, great breakaway speed, draws himself a penalty shot.
LA's been awarded a penalty shot, Nashville holding.
Look at that speed. He pulls away. He's fast. He can notice it right from the drop of the puck. You can see the wheels that he has and tries to pull it back, and Carrier ties him up a little bit. Didn't look that bad to me, but enough to get the ref's attention.
Kempe with 14 goals to lead the Kings. He's stopped by Saros.
Juice.
Saros shut the door.
How calm and cool is that? Just nice and easy. Track the puck, eyes on it, all the way. And you can see that. I know Mace talks about it all the time, but.
Now, we have a straight, why is everybody stopped right now?
They're boycotting. The Preds need to come out first as the Kings get a last change.
Okay.
Now they're gonna go out there.
That was very odd. I had that they waited a good 8 Mississippi before the Predators sent anybody over the boards.
Yeah, I don't know what that was all about. I wonder if John Hines had something to say about it.
Well, of course, the crowd got silenced because Saros stopped the shot, so everybody was sitting here. It's like you could hear a pin drop.
Well, I know Mace talks about it all the time, but the way that Saros tracks the puck with his eyes, you can see him. He stares that puck all the way into his blocker and makes the save. That's just so good. It's just so smooth.
Well, Alex Perrier will be thanking UC Saros after the game on the flight to Arizona. Here comes Janot powering in. His shot is blocked. Bjorn Foot. Now it's Prennan's turn. His shot is blocked as well.
Now it's time for tonight's hot ticket time. Why not start your new year in Smashville? Just scan the QR code on your screen and receive a 20% discount off your purchase of any weekday game in January.
There you go.
It's a hot ticket.
Nice job. Skillsy's stepping in just fine with the reads. You got plenty of experience with the radio side with that, don't you?
Unbelievable that I can read. Is that what you're saying, Will?
That's not what I'm saying.
All right. I guess I'm just...
You know, it's a little different vibe in the TV booth.
Just a dumb hockey player, right, Willie? Wow, good job reading.
He's off wind. Meyer's a blast, and that was blocked. Now a two-on-one developing for the Kings if they hurt. Anderson shot. Saros with a stick save into the corner. Cousins got a stick on it. Now Borbietti low leverage again. And from his knees, Cousins finds the open man. Now Myers works it to center. Backhanded forward by Luck. Luck comes flying in there. Doughty sidesteps it. 6 minutes gone by in the second. Luck's goal coming at 2:49. Ekholm, a good backhand play. Forsberg banks it for Duchesne and comes back towards Ekholm. This one on goal. Quick will have to play it to the corner. An errant pass. Duchesne has an open man. Benning! What a save by Quick! Ooh. He snagged it. That one was ticketed right under the bar. Matt Benning shaking his head. Matt Luff, the former LA King. Yes, that feels good. Second period, UC Saros stopping the Adrian Kempe penalty shot. That leads us to the Taco Bell take. The stellar numbers here, how one after another, the first three you got, right? Those are your basic back of the hockey card stats. Then how about the last two, analytics style? Goals save above expected. He's number one in the league, 22 plus, more than average goalies. Then six steals, that means he basically stole the game based on the amount of quality that the Predators faced. The sixth steal was just two nights ago in Vegas.
Solid in every night. Night in, night out, that guy comes to play, and he's been a rock for the Preds.
Ways to quantify just how good he's been.
He's got get-it-done-ativity.
Yes, he does.
High grade.
And that is the Hal Gill analytic one that, that he goes by the most, I would say.
Yeah, the old eye test. He's good.
That's it from Caesar Sportsbook. Earlier today on 102.5 The Game, our flagship radio station that you're normally on at this point with Pete Weber, Elliot Friedman from Sportsnet said he believes that UC Saros is now becoming somebody who should be in the Hart Trophy discussion for the MVP.
Yeah, just give him whatever you can. Give him any trophy you can right now. He's the heart and soul of this team. Lots of people stepping up, but he's been the biggest for the Preds, certainly.
A hard wrist shot by Martin Furk with block. L.A. has had some good success winning offensive zone draws. Furk on his backhand trying to lead Kopitar up the ice. He overskates it. It's picked off by Josi. You don't see that very often by Kopitar. Chance to attack for the Predators. Granlin to Forsberg. Stick tied up. Forsberg almost was in the perfect spot. And what do we have? Played with a high stick. If you like Saturday Night Live... How about Pete Davidson in the house tonight?
What an absolute beauty.
I'll tell you what, he's got some interesting stuff going on.
King
of Staten Island.
King of Staten Island. He's something special. If you like laughing, you like that guy.
Wearing his sunglasses at night. We're not allowed to sing songs, though.
No, don't get me on that one. That Corey?
Corey Hart.
Corey Hart.
He's a Canadian. Chris Mason's got to like him, right? Eli Tolvanen playing catch with Luke Cunningham. He'll send it back Tolvanen's way. Now it gets around towards Josi. Kings looking down ice, a long pass. Arvidsson streaking up the ice using that speed. Moore makes the move on Josi. Now he meets Carrier. Talking to John Hines about this pair together. Carrier and Josi, both very active skaters. You had some great insight, Hal, on how you adjust your game depending on your partner.
Yeah, that's, you know, every partner is different. You just have to learn what makes them tick. But both those guys, great skaters, so they can be aggressive. That's what they've been doing really well.
They turn the puck over. Here's McCarron down the slot, drops it up. Borowiecki hit the outside of the net. Picked up McCarron with that big wingspan.
This line's going to work again.
McCarron's got daylight. Try to get it past Cunnin. Cunnin couldn't get out of the way. Borowiecki erases Arvidsson. Karen's still gliding around out there. This one off the glass, up for grabs. Nashville finishing a line change.
Not an easy job to do, to squeeze off Arvidsson the way Borowiecki just did. A strong finish on the boards, using his feet to catch up with him.
Well, speaking of Victor Arvidsson, let's look at our steel player comparison. Now, you might recall a couple of years ago, Victor Arvidsson in the 18-19 season was on fire. Ended up with 34 goals to set the franchise record. He even missed a bunch of games that year. Here is where Philip Forsberg compares to this stage of the season.
Yeah, Phil right on his heels and keeps at him up. When you can shoot at 93 miles and with a wrist shot, you'll get there. You'll find a way to score goals, right?
So that's goals over a 20-game span is the comparison we were actually showing you. Forsberg is added to that total tonight. Tapari trying to make a move is juggled by Trenum. Trenum taking a little page out of Forsberg's book there. Juggling the puck with the stick. Now it's Chenault. He just busts through one wall of defense. Now gets into the corner. He'll work against Lemieux. Finds Colton Sissons. Sissons on his back here. Chased up the boards. Leaves it there for Carrier. Tapari wrestling with Carrier, who wins the battle. Trenum. Banging with Bjornflot. Trenum places it into an open corner. Nice keep in. Carrier skates away. Then fans on the shot, and it's a breakaway for Brown. Dustin Brown, all by himself. He scores!
Well, a tough break there for Carrier. He makes a beautiful move to keep that in. Tries to drag it and pull it around, change the angle on the shot, fans on it, and it's Dustin Brown, the full length, a good hard power move, gets Saros to bite on it, brings it back to the forehand. A lot of time to think about it. Saros in great position. What a move that is from Brown. Sells the shot, brings it to the backhand, forehand slam the door.
So a big turn of events. Alex Carrier made a brilliant play to keep the puck on the blue line, then he eluded a defender. He got into a great position to shoot and then just lost the puck.
Yeah, it's going to happen from time to time, and Carrier has been so good. You don't want him to lose that creativity on the blue line. You want him to be moving. We just talked about how him and Josi have really worked well with each other because they are moving so much, making plays. But with all that creativity, you're going to have some miscues. That was a little tough break, and it's not always going to be roses, right?
Now it is Forsberg attacking, runs into a bunch of black jerseys. So we'll see if the Kings can build off of that. They got the crowd back into it. It was a very quiet building. This is one of the bigger venues in the league, and it's a great venue. Nashville had taken the crowd out of it early. Here's Doughty sizing it up, cycling out high, Kopitar. Three-man weave, the shot, stopped by Saros, rebound into the circle, tracked down by Kempe. Kempe winds up, hammers one, that goes wide as Saros kicks it up and out of play. So Dustin Brown gets his fifth of the year as we move past the halfway point of regulation. It's 3-1.
Yakov Trenum tallied a goal last game in the Preds' win over Vegas. I actually rode the elevator down with him at the team hotel before the game. He told me how excited he was for the game because he'd never been to Vegas. I also asked Coach Hines this morning about what he likes in Yakov's game from what he's seen so far this season. Coach said the biggest difference in his game this year has been how consistent he has become. At the end of last season, the coaching staff challenged Yakov to play a more north-south game. He wanted him to use his size more and work on his body position. Hines said he feels that Yakov is now very consistent in all of these areas. Guys?
Yeah, he's playing the right way. That's what he's doing, and they've worked with him to keep his game simple, and he's got good hands, he's got good speed. Was that his 100th game, too, I think, right?
Lindsay? Yes, it was.
Yeah, that
yes,
was.
It was.
100th game in Vegas, gets a goal.
You see, Trenton on the bench, one of the things that was going on during the break, they had to call security down to keep an eye on the fans in the front row right on the glass behind the Predators' bench. Dowdy off the faceoff, another one draw for the Kings. A blast, stopped by Saros through traffic. Kopitar had the screen. Don't have the official stats on how many offensive zone draws they've won, but it is a bunch by the Kings, and they're getting offense off of it.
Puck possession is key. Get the puck, you get to make good chances.
Simple concept, win the draw, you get the puck. Here comes Duchesne on the counter. He has one of the three goals that Nashville scored. The first two in the first period were both on the power play. Johansson looks to the high slot. It's deflected, short, through the legs, banks it. Johansson absorbs the check by Kopitar and a lead Duchesne back in. Duchesne centering pass looking for Tolvanen. Duchesne last man off from that far wing. Now they'll complete the line change. Luke Cunning comes in. Meanwhile, the Kings in a full change. Johansson works it in deep. Deneau wipes out on his own. Here comes Arvidsson to support. Arvidsson to the line. Nashville jams up the neutral zone. Cunning finds the big fella, number 92. Johansson coming in on the forecheck, along with Tolman. King's able to break out. Johansson wiped out. Here's Moore circling, and he missed it high. McCarron gets into the play. He came in for Johansson. Johansson is hurting on the bench right now. Not sure what happened.
He just dumped it in, and I didn't see anything happen after that.
He is doubled over, trying to shake it off.
Nice move from Moore on the entry.
Now here's a stretch pass. Oh, man, Lazat was wide open. And a great play by Saros to delay everything by getting a stick on that puck off the backboard. Lazat has it back now. Centering pass in tight. Saros with the save. And now some activity after the whistle. Borowiecki jumps in against Lemieux in a big pile up in the corner.
Well, Cousins went right after Lemieux and grabbed him, pulled him out. Lemieux wanted no part of that and kind of lost his mind. That's what Lemieux will do. Watch your fingers, buddy. He just got in.
Yeah, he's got a reputation.
He got a reputation. He had a little biting incident.
They're screaming at each other. Hal's reference, of course, Lemieux was suspended for biting.
There's no Brady biting Kachuk. In hockey.
Here's the save. Now watch. There's
nice
contact.
Play, nice save, and then Cousins tries to get him out. Borowiecki comes in.
Now Lemieux is headed to the penalty box.
Let's see
if Borowiecki is as well. Here's the shakeout. Well, the referee's mic is not working, but it looks like two for Borowiecki and two for Lemieux. Lemieux is just throwing stuff all around in the penalty box there. He is hot.
Yeah, he's having a little fit in there.
Well, he tried to reach in with the stick after Saros had it. They call it, Mace likes to call it the pitchfork,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And so that's what the Predators responded to.
You know, you play to the whistle, and I think Saros had that puck, but it was maybe loose in his gear, and he's going after it. I don't blame him. That's what you want to do, especially against a good goalie like Juice. Go in there and dig in, get dirty. And try to get Saros off his game while you're getting the goal. And I think the Preds have been good all year at standing up for each other, and absolutely you're going to stand up for Juice.
You can tell the Kings just trying desperately to get back in this game. They've outshot the Predators 21-11. So they feel like they've done some good things.
Yeah, and they have, and that's that play right there, getting it behind the net, working it towards the front, and jamming it. They're going to see a lot more of that, I assume, as they try to get back into this game.
4-on-4 hockey. Here comes Kempe. A lot on that. Josie got enough of it to send it wide. Josie will draw Doughty in and flip it back to Matt Duchesne. Josie and Carrier, Duchesne and Granlin. Granlin stops just inside the line, looks and leads Duchesne. Duchesne, a wicked wrist shot. Changes direction, bounces out to Josie. He'll weave it to Granlin. Granlin hands it off. Josie builds speed. Looking for Duchesne, could not quite connect. Granlin back to the net. Quick wasn't quite back in set position.
Doughty almost deflected it in himself.
And Josie lost it. He was trying to get it back to Carrier. On the counter, here come the Kings with speed. And a great play by Josie. He broke it up, but he had to control that puck. He almost sent it back to his own goalie. Now Nashville needs a change. Duchesne still hanging out there, holding off Roy. Now he'll head for the bench. Carrier will buy some time, and then he's got to get off. Here comes Johansson. Johansson and Forsberg have had some deadly combination moves on the four-on-four the last couple of games.
Yeah, they're looking for each other, and they know how to find each other. And we talk about Arvey. We all remember Jofa, the Jofa line. They always worked well together.
Well, they're all out there right now. Just one of them's wearing a different jersey.
That's right.
6:05 to play in the second. Kings with possession. 22 seconds left in the four-on-four. Ekholm sees the opportunity to play the puck. He couldn't find Johansson. Bjornqvist will retreat. Johansson pushes him back. Forsberg now will head to the bench. Granlin comes back on. Roy works it back to Bjornqvist. Out to the wing. Here's Arvidsson. His shot missed the top. Out of the box comes Lemieux and Borowiecki. Borowiecki will make the simple play and send it in deep. Lemieux with Duchesne on his tail. Back to five-a-side now. Here's Deneau. Got crunched by McCarron. Saros will stop play. 5:25 to play in the middle period. Nashville holding a 3-1 lead. Mikey McGuire, and he is going in for back surgery here in the very near future. We want to wish him well. He, of course, is one of the leaders of the Best Buddy crew, right?
Yeah.
Pekka-Rinne, Shea Weber, so instrumental going back to when Barry Trotz was the coach. And Mike McGuire, man, you talk about somebody who loves this team.
Well, and the team loves him. He's one of the first people I met when I got
to
the Preds. Peck said, hey, you got to meet my buddy here. And Mikey, always a smile, always making everyone around him happy. Good luck, Mikey. We love you, bud.
Yep, he's going to come out of this just fine. And we will see him back in Smashville very soon. Now through the neutral zone, here's Brown. He got his team on the scoreboard. He'll challenge Saros. The rebound, kicked right off the referee. Settles in the corner. Cousins down on his knees. He's got an assist in this period. He joined us late, Matt Luff scored the third goal. Former L.A. King, his first goal as a Nashville Predator.
Now, Willie, you talked about how this team plays, and they don't give up many chances. You can look at these goals allowed, ninth in the league, expected goals allowed, six. They don't give up too many shots, and they don't give up too many attempts. And the Preds have been fortunate. The shots right now, 23-11.
Yeah, it's really played out the way
it's exactly
should,
right.
Except for the goals allowed. The Predators have had a high percentage of cashing in.
Yeah.
It's a good thing.
They got it done at Tivity. That's it.
Well, two of the goals on the power play, too. And if you were to look five on five, it's even less. Here's Cousins trying to split a couple of defenders. A backhander just wide. Cousins creating. He almost ran the gauntlet.
He's got a sneaky little step on him, doesn't he? He's got some speed.
It's a good season. Cousins picks up a loose puck now at the blue line. He'll bring it in on the attack. He's got two-thirds of the herd with him. Here's Jeannot coming in to help. Now Cousins will make his way back to the bench. Trennan will come on. This one floated high by Drew Doughty. It bounces past Myers. He looks over his shoulder to see what's coming. He'll make the play to Borowiecki. Borowiecki up the board to Jeannot, kept in at the line by Lazat. Loose puck. Spinning around, got it to center. This line has been a thorn in the side of the Predators, but Borowiecki just absolutely blasted it. And now we've got a response. This has been brewing for a while. Here we go, Borowiecki and Lemieux. Borowiecki just lit up Kaliev, and now Borowiecki, the chainsaw left.
Yeah,
Lemieux trying to wrestling move here.
Yeah, Lemieux put on the seatbelt. He didn't want to chuck him. He wanted to tie up as quick as he could. Moro trying to get that left out. That's smart by Lemieux. He doesn't want any part of that. He'll grind out a fight, but he doesn't want to unleash him.
Lemieux just throwing some blind rights off the helmet of Borowiecki, not much mustard on.
Moro's just waiting to try to get one little opening.
Well, now let's see how they call it, Hal. It'll be another example. Borowiecki had a legal hit along the boards, and it was not Lemieux. Lemieux came over. So is that an instigator or not?
You know what? It's a legal hit, and it's a great hit because he closes time and space.
5 minutes fighting.
Yeah, he jumps up on his gap and smokes him. I don't know how that, when we've talked about it, it's up for interpretation. What is an instigator penalty and what isn't? He comes right over to him after he makes that hit. And John Hines is looking around confused again. That Boro had one earlier. That was since rescinded. The league looked at it and said, we're going to take it away, which...
That was in Washington.
I don't think Borowiecki was happy about that because he was leading the league in pins. And then they took it away. He's got 12 minutes taken away from his pins.
Well, he's got five more added there. And he had two earlier in the period.
He is tough. That was smart by Lemieux not to go toe-to-toe with him.
Here's Janot with Kempe on him. Kempe throws the shoulder into Janot. Janot got it up the boards for Trennan. Trennan insists it's coming in tandem, following up Janot. Janot turns to his forehand. Interchanging. Here's Carrier. All the way to the net! Stopped by Quick. Quick lost the stick on the play. Roy with Trennan trying to power his way past him. On the angle. Sisson tried the feed. He had a good idea there. Trennan was open in the slot. Buck deflected. Play continues. Nashville and a quick line change here. Trennan barrels into Roy. Roy absorbed that well. Buck hanging out outside the line. Picked up by Kempe. This one deflected. Out of play. 3:10 to play in the second. Forsberg, Duchesne, and Luff for the Predators. Dustin Brown for the Kings.
Yeah, it's funny how it was a fast game, and then it kind of got slowed down. The Preds kind of slowing down the game and playing it their way, and then it got feisty. It got a little chippy, and I expect to see a lot more of the Kings trying to crash the net, create some more scoring chances, get by Juice. But with that, you're going to see a lot more of that chippy play, and the Preds have shown over and over again that they're up to it. It used to come in to L.A., and L.A. was heavy and hard. You remember those years.
Yeah,
there was
tough
to play
teams.
Against. And the Preds maybe couldn't compete. Things have changed.
Such a theme of the season that we seem to be talking about every night.
Yeah, and it's a big part of it. It's a whole team mentality that they have.
Predators on game two of a three-game Western swing. It'll end in Arizona on Saturday. And then the Predators will come home to take on the Colorado Avalanche on Tuesday. That's one you want to be at over in Smashville. Johansson comes in with an active stick, crashing in his loop cunning. But Luth, now it's at the net front, jamming away at it. Tolvanen.
Here we go.
Quick,
Mark,
holding
Mark,
his
Mark.
Ground. And now you've got, look at this. We got
Joey
Arvidsson and
Irving.
Joey. Arvidsson and Johansson. Oh, boy. Good buddies. But just not right now. Oh, and then we got more action.
You got a different jersey, pal. And all bets are off.
But this is one how, once again, you identify the makeup of these teams. The Predators have the deeper toughness, size, muscle.
And they made a point of doing that in the offseason. They changed the mentality. They talked about it, and we were all questioning, how is that going to work out? Well, we're seeing it.
And now what's the
here,
call?
Here, crashing the net. Oh, that's it.
So only Johansson.
He was outnumbered. He had four.
Yossi said, wait a minute, you're supposed to
call
one of them.
I'm not sure how that translates. Good battle in heavy on the forecheck. Get it to the net. Crash and bang. Tolvanen digging in there. Arvidsson came in and gave it to Johansson. Johansson.
Look at them, they're laughing at each other.
I don't know how you call just one out of that.
Well, they did. So it'll be
I guess
a power
that's
play.
How they did it.
Kings, their second chance on the power play. They had all kinds of heat against the Predators back in the first period. So a big moment in the game here. And they win the faceoff again. Ferk to Dart. Backdoor feed for Ferk. Pass deflected on the way. Ferk still made a play out. Arvidsson is leveled by Matt Benning. Janot attacking shorthanded against three defenders. Janot powers his way behind the net. Passes it to the point. Arvidsson gets back in there. Arvidsson's so tough. Nobody is hit as much, in my opinion, as
Arvidsson. He takes a beating. He leaves himself exposed.
I mean, there are stats to back that up. And but Arvidsson just absorbs it.
He just gets corked over and over. He still plays, still gets back up. He's a tough kid.
Nashville gets the clear with under 2 minutes to play in the period now. A minute 16 to go in Johansson's penalty.
A lot of times he's getting hit at full speed, too. And he can scoot.
Kempe looked like he got a screen from Doughty. Nashville was hollering for an interference penalty. They got away with it. Doughty, one-timer stopped by Saros. Quick reaction. Ferk let it go. Doughty. Backhand feed for Kempe. Now the defenseman down low to the side of the net, Kopitar. Good anticipation by Granlund. Works it three. Reaching forward, Trennan. He can't get it out. It's loose. Right in front. Everybody going down. And a great clear by Granlund.
Great anticipation from Granlund to disrupt the play, and then it gets to the net, and he battles to find that puck. Great competitor, Granlund.
He sticks his nose in there to the wing. A little opening. Kick save, Saros. Rebound on the slot. Stop the follow-up as well. A brilliant save by UC Saros. This one deflected. It's a race for the puck. Janot. Sisson's coming with him. Sisson's coming back. Moore fell down very easily. Janot sees the puck, chases it. 2 seconds to go. Johansson will come out of the box with 34 seconds remaining in the period. Nashville has killed off another. Janot attacks. Justin Brown. Lateral pass. Caught up in the skates of Ekholm. Swept into the corner. And now Nashville has a 3-on-2 if they hurry. Johansson out of the box. Trailing in Johansson. Now down low for Forsberg. Ekholm sees his opportunity is done. He'll give way. Myers comes on. 8 seconds to go in the period.
Quick. They're all caught up with each other.
Still time. 4 seconds to go. Brown to the net. Gloved down by Saros. And then Anderson got a piece of Saros. That won't be appreciated very much. Myers trying to calm things down with Dustin Brown.
Well, Ekholm's losing it. Johansson just got caught up in front.
Nashville number 92, 2 minutes roughing.
Another penalty on the Predators.
Kind of bizarre play. I'm not sure how he got tangled up with. You know, Hines is looking around curious as well. He's off to the side of the net and he takes a little jab and it's quick holding his leg. And I guess away from the play, I'm sure the ref wasn't looking at the goaltender. Just saw the after effects of that and it looked like Johansson gave him a little swipe.
Well, the Predators are getting a look at the monitor on the bench. Mattias Ekholm still in a very spirited conversation right now with Jake Brink, the official. There are 3/10 of a second left, so Kopitar will try to shoot this puck.
Yeah, that's a missed call there by the referee. He didn't see the hold from Quick.
So nonetheless,
unfortunately, they can't go back and look at it.
Smart play by Sissons to just block the attempted shot by Kopitar. And so Johansson, who just came out of the penalty box, will start the third period back in it. So each team with a goal in the second period. The shot counter favoring the Kings 14-8 in the second period and 27-14 unofficially through two. Mattias Ekholm still getting a few extra words in as we get set for the Jack in the Box intermission. We'll be talking to Dan Heinorn in a moment.
Try Jack in the Box's new perfectly spicy $5.99 spicy cluck sandwich combo and by selected Chevy dealers.
Ready to set sail for the third period here at Crypto.com Arena in Los Angeles. Nashville leading 3-1. They will be on the penalty kill. Now it's time to take a look at the FanDuel Sportsbook Check the Lines. Philip Forsberg scored the first goal of the game. You see the payoff there. So Forsberg continues his torrid pace. He's got a goal and an assist. You can also see in the background the spirited conversation going on. The Predators coaching staff not happy at all with a number of calls. Here's the latest one that happened in the final second of play of the second period. You look at Jonathan Quick there.
There's a culmination of about three different events that I really don't think that John Hines is happy about. This is the last one right at the end of the period. You can see Quick starts that. Hey, kids, if you're watching, they always get the retaliation. They missed the beginning part of that, and Hines was furious. I think they're also talking about a couple other things. I think he wanted an instigator with Lemieux on Borowiecki. I also think he was questioning that penalty shot penalty. I don't think Terrier did much to deserve a penalty anyway.
Well, you got a very good look at Johansson and Quick there, and it was only Johansson that got the penalty. So power play for the Kings to start the third period. Asheville holding the two-goal lead, but it's a bit precarious. They've been outshot 27-14. And as you heard Dan Hynote in our interview, he said he thinks the Kings have been the more aggressive team. They've outworked the Predators, which is saying something.
Yeah, they have. They played a pretty solid game. They haven't gotten rewarded. A couple posts. Preds have been fortunate to get the goals that they did.
Kopitar to Dottie. Kopitar shooting. Arvidsson had the screen. A big bounce, and it gets across the line. So a chance to get back to the bench for Ekholm. And a partial change. Josi comes in. Now Trennan and Granlund will go off. Nashville has to complete this line change in a hurry. Dowdy sees some space. Cross ice pass for Firth.
60 on the penalty.
Out to the point, Kempe. You hear the communication going on the ice with the time left in the penalty. Kempe working the near side with Firth. Harassed by Janot. Out to Arvidsson. Arvidsson to the side of the net. Kopitar. Pass deflected. And it's banged down the ice by Sissons.
Textbook rotations from the top forwards. You had Sissons and Janot pushing everything to the outside, and then a good long body take away the crease and the backdoor play. Get the puck, send it down. That's textbook stuff right there.
New five on the ice. Moore attacks the middle. And it's whacked out of there by Ekholm. McCarron will head back to the box. He will not chase the puck carrier. Now a lot of the youngsters out there. The veteran is Deneau. Deneau takes over in the corner. He'll wind it around for another veteran, Dustin Brown. He owns the lone goal for the Kings so far. Lost stick on the ice belonging to Granlund. Open man in the slot. Tic-tac-toe in front. A spinning shot is stopped by Soros. Oh, Soros had a lot to contend with coming in on his blind side, but he's able to hold the fort.
Oh, Soros thought he had it, and the ref thought that he had it, so he blew the early whistle. I think that puck is still alive. Off a shin pad by Deneau. He makes a big save. That's not an easy deflection. A huge stop, and then he tries to cover it up, and that puck was on the backside. Another whack at it after the whistle.
King's complaining.
A good break, yeah.
They probably should not have blown the whistle, but no. Soros made the next save anyway.
Yeah, well, hey, you know, he thought he had it under his glove. He must assume there's two pucks out there because he threw out the pad as well.
So Johansson comes out of the penalty box. It's five aside. Another shot. That one changed directions, went high. Kings keep the heat on again. Nashville weathered a big storm in the first period and came out of there with a 2-0 lead with a pair of power play goals. Nashville built the lead to 3-0. Then a goal by Dustin Brown cut it to 3-1. Now it's Duchesne operating deep in the offensive zone. Duchesne, he owns the second goal tonight, his 14th of the year. Pass out high to Borowiecki. Tees it up and fires off the backboard. Looking for the rebound is Forsberg. Duchesne had a chance to stuff it in from a tough angle.
Oh, silky little move there from behind the net. A little toe drag.
Pretty crafty. Duchesne has it again. Now he hits a streaking Josi. Josi sidesteps one man. Works over Duchesne. Duchesne waits. Shoots. It's stopped by Quick. Rebound centered in front. Forsberg shoots. That was blocked. John Kersey. Nashville, all of a sudden, hit the throttle. Powerful shift by the top skilled players on the team. Now Tolvanen, coming in strong on the forecheck. Quick was able to get the pass away. Now Lemieux, trying to hold off Johansson. Nobody's happy with Lemieux. He's just going to continue to try to stir it up out there. centering pass, turned back by Carrier. He was in the right spot. Carrier and Yossi trying to get out of trouble. Outlet pass, Colvin, and kicks it ahead for Luke Cunning. Now gets it back. Johansson will work the wing. Johansson, touch pass. Colvin wipes out. Picked up by Roar. Counter attack for the Kings. Lemieux tried to fire it past Cunning. Cunning blocked it. Roy gets his own pass back. Stopped by Soros, who was in that position, the reverse VH, if I'm correct. I'll have to check with Mace on that. Had that lower part of the net covered.
He stopped it.
Whatever it was, it worked. 4 minutes gone by. Fast pace to the third period. Johansson muscles it back to neutral territory. Kopitar whips it across to Dowdy. Now Kopitar comes back in. Hands it off. Centering pass. Burke sent it wide. Soros lunging for it. Kempe. Top line out there for the Kings. They double-team Kopitar. Man open on the opposite side. Dowdy. Save. Rebound stopped again. Kopitar with the puck a third time. Two great saves by Soros. King sizing it up again. Benning gets a new stick. By the way, Pete Rogers back on the bench to hand it off.
With the quick stick, yes.
Here's the drop pass on the counter. Sissons and Trennan. Trennan tried to shoot it through the defender. Duchesne has to wait for a tag out. Now he does. Duchesne weaving his way past out. Kopitar picks it off. Trying to keep it in. It's Forsberg against his good buddy Victor Arvidsson. Pass to the line. Duchesne dropped it back blindly just out of the reach of Granlund. Myers fires it around. Myers looks a little more assertive out there. Here's Granlund. Pump fakes. Hangs onto the puck and he's pushed off the play by Deneau. Comes back around. Borowiecki looks to the net foot. To the high slot, Duchesne. Pass ahead. Arvidsson was free for a moment. Good recovery by Myers. Duchesne still out there at the end of a long shift. He'll attack again. Duchesne gets to the slot. Can't quite beat the last man. Durzi just had enough to hold him off. Puck juggled at the line. Sent back in. Both teams were going to change it. Hit the stick that was still sitting there in the corner.
A lot of back and forth action right now. The Preds would love to see a little more offensive zone time. Get it in deep and grind it out a little bit more.
Now the line that authored the third goal. Shot by Yossi, got glass behind the net. Cousins and McCarron working on the near side. Luff had the goal, assisted by his two forward line mates in the second period. Now it's Yossi. Cousins from the point, a sinking shot wide.
Yeah, this is what they're looking for. Work down low, get it back to the point, get pucks to the net. Retrievals, keep it going, get a line change and go back at her.
Cousins stirring it up with Brown as they crisscross with one another to head back to the bench. Lazat was able to slip past one man, dumped it in. The stick is still down there. Ekholm avoids it. Nashville looks to get speed coming through the neutral zone. Johansson gliding in on his backhand. Swoop out to Bennett. This one got through. Quick had it. Thought he had lost it, but he had it the whole time. Fast pace in the third period. 13:07 to go in the third. Featured player of the game is Philip Forsberg. Go to NashvillePredators.com/HuntBrothers and enter Forsberg's name along with your contact info for a chance to win four tickets to an upcoming Predators home game, plus the Hunt Brothers pizza. Also, don't forget, at the end of this game, we will be giving you Predators Live, presented by Farm Bureau Health Plans. Lindsey Rally will be working the locker room tonight. There'll be plenty to talk about one way or another, depending on how this one ends. We'll have the highlights and analysis as well.
Yeah, it's been a heck of a game so far. You know, you look at these teams and it, Kings were really buzzing and it's become physical, and Reds have had some opportunities and they buried them. But we're in one down the stretch. This is going to be good. Deuce has been fantastic. The last cluster of saves was awesome.
Pretty remarkable. Here they come again. Anderson speeding around the corner, tried to center it. Deflected by Carrier. Yossi got jammed up with Johansson at the line. Now they have to hustle back. Here's the shot. Soros swallows it up. Hey, Saturday, you've got men's ACC hoops. A doubleheader coming your way, starting at 11 Central. Clemson against the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. Then at 1 o'clock, the second game will be Syracuse taking on Wake Forest. It's on Bally Sports South and the Bally Sports app. So the Predators have been outshot by a ratio of 2-1 here, Hal.
Well, you got that guy right there, so you're good.
Well, that's what that's the feeling you get. He has stopped 78 of 81 in his last two starts coming in, and he's going to have a high volume when it's all over tonight well.
They got to clean up the defensive zone, get some stops.
Kempe tries to make the one-on-one move, and the Predators are going to go on the power play here.
Well, that was a good stop there for Ekholm to get on Kempe, a speedster, and he took away time and space. And you guess you could say he drew the penalty, right?
That's a welcome sight. Well, got to work the batteries in the microphone there, but we got the message, the high stick. Trevor Hansen with the call.
This is a great job using his stick to predict where that puck is going to go and putting his hand on his back. That's textbook defense there from Ekholm. Kempe loses the puck and swings back to try to find it and found Matthias Ekholm's face.
This is where Nashville has swung the game in their favor. That. 2-for-2 on the power play, 3-for-3 on the penalty kill. Moore chips it to the line. Forsberg with the keep in. He's got an open man. Josi drifting to the wing. Draws a couple of defenders. Behind the net for Mikhail Granlund. Granlund has an assist tonight. Josi has a pair of assists. Josi from the circle into the high slot. Almost bounced right back to him for a shot. Forsberg keeps it in. Forsberg manning the point right now, and it's clear. There's that rotation of the five players.
That's what Coach Lambert has talked about doing. Wants to have guys interchanging, moving in different spots, being unpredictable. That time just a little bit overthinking, I think. You know, Yossi's looking for a bunch of different options and just kind of waited a little bit too long and it closed in around him.
Duchesne building speed with Johansson, gets the return feed. Duchesne scored on a play similar to that in the first period. This one cleared by Doughty on net. Soros had a lot to handle there.
The old Skippy. Try to skip it in long distance.
I used to like to skip rocks at the lake. Yeah, that's a crowd for a skip
thing.
Like that.
Yeah,
that's what you're looking for.
Exactly.
Second unit is on. Perrier crashing in to open up space for Cousins. Cousins in the corner. Return feed to the point. Luke Cunningham now straight away. Ekholm. Cunningham gets it back. Fires. That's where Forsberg scored from in the first period. That exact spot. Now Tolvanen approaches. Time ticking down. To the side of the net. Cousins to the middle. Cousins didn't get much on it. Stopped by Quick. He got into that dangerous scoring area. It stays inside the line. Ekholm, one more chance. 15 seconds to go. They set it up for Tolvanen. Saucer pass got away from Cousins and it's cleared to center. Kempe standing up now, ready to come out of the box in 5 seconds. Ekholm will attack one last time. Ekholm. Plays it in diagonally. It comes off the board for Cunningham. Out of the box comes Kempe, and the teams are back to five aside, pouncing on a loose puck to King. Here they come. Durzi, he's going to draw a penalty. And now the Kings will go back on the power play.
That's tough one. Tolvanen tracking back hard, doing the right thing. Put a stick in there, just couldn't get it back out.
2 minutes for hooking.
Not sure if that was a hook or a fall down or a trip.
Well, look, he's grabbing the stick. Durzi has a hold of Tolvanen's stick. He grabbed the shaft of it.
There's a reason he couldn't get it back out, right?
I'll tell you what.
I'm sure John Hines is loving that one.
Well, he probably hasn't even seen it clearly. And once he does, he won't be very happy at all.
Lasers coming out of his eyes as he looks at the ref.
There's the reaction. John Hines is...
Yikes.
You know, he is not usually that demonstrative on the bench when you get down to it.
It's been a snowball with a bunch of bad calls, I think, that are getting under his skin.
Predators, penalty kill again, back to the wall. Second one in this period. Arvidsson, blocker saved by Saros. Puck to the point, Janot. Right, come back to Kopitar, they play catch with it. Arvidsson.
Good coverage, good coverage.
Drew Doughty to Kopitar. A shot. Stops the rebound. Off the side of the cage. Throwing out the pad with Saros. He might have got a piece. Kopitar regroups. Doughty on the cycle to Arvidsson. Doughty winds up. Instead, here's the shot. They score. It's Martin Furk hanging out on the far side. His first game this year for the Kings, and he tallies a very big power play goal.
Well, the Kings just taking what's given to them. The Preds doing a great job of rotating. Eventually, it gets over. That's a perfect shot. Nothing flashy about that. Good sell there by Doughty, but other than that, it's just a heck of a shot inside that post. A little bit of a screen there that confused Saros just for a second, and he looked back on the other side of that screen and the puck was already in.
So the Predators came in having killed 30 of 31 in the previous eight games. They were four for their first four tonight.
Well, that's a tough one. You're doing everything right. It just, you know, it's not fair. They have too many guys on the ice.
That's right. Sooner or later, one of them's going to go in.
Yeah.
So Nashville is going to have to try to calm things down, show some poise here. The lead has gone from 3-0 to 3-2.
No, you're on the bench. You say, guys, all right, let's get back to our game. You know, we can't protect this lead. We got to go and play hockey.
Here they come again. It's Brown. Brown, give and go. Centering pass. Granlund in the right spot. Had it. He got bumped off the puck. Now it's Elias Andersson. Carrier dropped the stick. Was out of the play for a moment. They swing it over to Roy. Into the high slot, Brown. Got twisted around. Nashville takes advantage. Scooped ahead. Forsberg with Granlund. Forsberg moves inside. What a play. A creative shot and a dirty. Great save by Quick. Did you see what Forsberg did? The latest piece of Swedish sorcery.
A little smile and wow, what a move that was.
But Furk has cut it to one. Oh. Forsberg.
First of all, there's so many things he's looking at here. First of all, he wants a shot. He sees that stick come in, so he just pulls it away from it. And then as soon as he gets that guy to commit, now he's trying to bring it back to him, get on the other side. That's exactly what he does. And then that's not easy to do, to get the look at the smirk on
like,
his face.
Oh, I had it.
He knows that was going to be another highlight reel goal. It's the hard part about doing that is getting that shot off so quickly, and he almost snuck it by Quick.
I just wonder if he's like sits on the bus or in his hotel room and just thinks up these moves, like, okay, what if I did this?
Well, if you watch him in practice, he does it all the time where he just messes around with a stick and flips it and catches it and does, you know, little toe drag, reverse toe drag. He's doing this stuff all the time. It's just a matter of time before he incorporates it into his game.
Well, it's turned into another white knuckler here, just like Tuesday in Vegas. Nashville up 3-0, have the lead, cut to 2. Or cut to 3-2, I should say. Trennan almost stole one right there. Bouncing puck at the blue line, fought off by the Predators. Trennan had the pass stolen. Kempe, he's been very active tonight. Kempe maneuvering all the way to the corner. Top line out there for the Kings. Kempe erased by Janot. A powerful hit. Puck loose. Bjornfoot tries to stuff it in, and Saros has it. Let's hear from Chevy.
Chevy Silverado. When only the strongest, most advanced will do. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
You see Saros so good at squeezing off the post. This is just a stuff attempt. When you're behind the net, you bring it out in front, and good things happen when you get into the crease. That's all they're trying to do. Young defenseman Bjornfoot just trying to jam it in. Juice holding the post tight.
Still 7:38 to go. You see Saros has given up an average, or I should say the Predators, have given up an average of over 40 shots a game in the last two. And as we mentioned before, Saros stopped 78 of the 81 he faced in his last two wins. Tonight, pacing again to get over 40. He had 41 saves last night. That was a season high.
I think the Preds have taken the early lead, and you take the early lead, and the teams you're playing against, they're going to fire pucks. They're going to shoot. They're going to crash the net. So you have to expect a lot of shot volume, but Juice has been good, making saves left and right.
Cronin took a shot to the sternum from Trevor Moore, now trying to get back into play. Philip Deneau trying to wind out wide against Myers. Myers took him out.
A great takeout by Myers, moving his feet, getting forward and getting on the body.
They swing it around to Dowdy. Top of the circle, the shot. That's blocked by a sprawling Tolman. Another shot. That one changed directions. Huge traffic. Holding his ground with Saros. Arvidsson mixing it up with Myers in front of the net. Harvey Hustle. Offside. Arvidsson was so gassed, he didn't quite get back across the line in time.
Well, Myers and Arvidsson going back and forth with each other, but this is a heck of a block here. Gutsy play from Tolvanen. Eyes on the puck until the last second it's shot, and then he turns his head, leaves his whole body right there for the shot. And yeah, the coaches love that.
Face off in the neutral zone. Sent back in by Lemieux. Ekholm looking for his options. Lemieux tries to get a body on. Granlund loses the race to Movarare.
You know what, it's such an art form to block shots, and we saw that one from Tolvanen. He's staring at that puck, and it's not far from his face. If that one comes up, he's got to turn his head pretty quick. But a fearless block, getting right into it. As soon as that puck comes off the stick and he knows where he's going, then he's going to protect his face.
Face-off win, shot blocked. That was Forsberg. Lazat trying to work himself free. Just inside the line. Good battle. Lazat tries to angle to the net. Followed up. And the shot stopped by Saros. That was Kaliev. Lazat has an open man at the point. It's Roy. Roy into the net traffic. Saros sees it. Good box out. Granlund holding off Kaliev.
Now this line has been buzzing too. Kaliev. Good young prospect that they're hoping is going to become something special. And Lazat, he's shifty, isn't he? He's buzzing around. Then they get traffic
he's
at the net.
He's played very well.
They're getting traffic to the net, and Juice with another big stop. Looked like he was going to poke that one out. Decided, let's just kill this, slow this game down as much as possible. You're playing on the road against a team that's coming in hot. They're playing well. They're buzzing. Take as many draws as you can and slow this whole thing down.
Showing confidence in McCarron's line to take this defensive zone draw. And Kopitar's line comes out. Todd McClellan sees a chance to go up against the fourth line. Played with a high stick. What do you think of that move, Hal? Some coaches would never send their fourth line out there in a situation like this, but this team is confident.
Well, it's the whole thing. If you believe in what your guys can do out there, you can get shifts in the defensive zone and save your top two lines for the offensive zone starts. Get those guys out there. Yeah, you can't play your top guys the whole time. This line has been good tonight. Why wouldn't you keep them out there?
Anderson nearly had happen to him what happened to Carrier in the second period. Nashville was leading 3-0. Carrier made a great play, and then fanned on the shot, sent Dustin Brown on a breakaway the other way, and that got the Kings going. Under 6 minutes to go. Dowdy a no-look pass, and this will be an icing.
That's textbook 1-3-1. That's what they're going to be looking for the rest of this game. Load up the neutral zone. Force a pass is out wide. That one doesn't connect, and you draw the icing. Now you get your first line out there for that offensive zone start. You can see everyone getting into position. Ready? Here it is. 1-3-1. Try to get through us, boys. Nope, it's not there. They take it away. Textbook 1-3-1.
Josi breaks the stick. He's got to hustle back to the bench. Benning will wait. Forsberg comes back to support. Matt Benning gains the red line and flicks it in. Off the railing it comes. Dowdy sends it around. Myers will swing it over to Borowiecki. Matt Duchesne gets the wheels turned. Duchesne attacks. Forsberg tries to go back to him. Puck deep. Forsberg hits off for a change. Crisscrossing down low. Granlund steals the puck to the slot. Tolvanen! A rising shot, partially blocked. But Tolvanen is due. Here he is again. Pounds one to the net. Knocked down in front. Duchesne tried to set the screen and get the tip. Tolvanen speeding back. Borowiecki. Fanned on the pass almost. It stays inside the line. A chance to attack for Arvidsson. Moment of trepidation. It's stolen again down low. Sit to the slot. Johansson got a stick on it. A race for the puck now. Myers couldn't clear it. Moore down low. Moore. Saved by Soros! Soros read the play. He had one guy on each post.
Wow.
Critical save for UC Soros. Tonight's performance of the game is brought to you by Bridgestone.
This is the Matt Luff goal, a beauty. Nice job getting it in deep and then getting it to the net by McCarron. He'll assist on Luff's first goal as a Pred. Beautiful finish off the rebound. Yeah, celebrate it, kid.
That came at 2:49 of the second period. Bridgestone, the official tire of the Nashville Predators. Nashville, at that point, led 3-0. Since then, the Kings have worked their way back to within one. A quick shot by Doughty. Soros not fooled. That is shot number 43 by the Kings.
It's not a recipe for wins, giving up that many shots, but if you're going to give up shots, those are the ones you give up. You cleared everyone out from the front of the net. It's pretty routine save for UC Soros.
Kopitar will take the draw. He's already won 17 faceoffs tonight.
He's just a moose in the draw, in the circle. He digs in, and it's tough to stop that strength that he's got.
Kirk turned back, juggled the puck for a moment, able to get it to Doughty. That's always a good play. Doughty and Kopitar along with Kempe. Kirk offside.
Ooh, that was
Alex
close.
Iafallo is usually the third man on that line. Firk has filled in admirably, though.
Well, he had that heater of a shot for the goal. That time just a little bit offsides. He looks good on that line with Kopitar and Kempe. I've been impressed with. Ton of speed. Everywhere he goes, he's bringing that speed with him.
Kings have won 57% of the faceoffs to Nashville's 43%. But some of the biggest ones are yet to happen here. 4 minutes to go. That one got hung up on his way around behind the net. The chase is on. Forsberg settles, cuts right up the middle. Able to get it to Josi. Now ahead for Granlund. Offside. Duchesne got tangled with the defender.
Yeah, you could debate whether he's pushed off or if he went off on his own. But Willie, you're talking about draws. I feel like the Preds need to commit, the forwards and the defensemen on the side of the circle need to commit a little bit more. They need to help out. You know, sometimes the best you can do is just tie up, and then you have to have one of the wingers come in and bump it back for you.
That is a point that probably needs to be made more. It's not just the guy that's taking the faceoff. It's the team, really, that has sometimes a factor in who wins the faceoff. Granlund down on the ice. Granlund now back up into play. You'll see him fighting for it. Benning comes over. Lemieux behind the net. Lemieux. And just getting a piece of it with Soros. All kinds of traffic around him. Lemieux again. Plucked down by Soros. Benning was battling on one side. Josi on the other. So they have gone with Benning and Josi down the stretch here, rather than Carrier and Josi, who started the game together.
Yeah, mixing it up a little bit. In the end, I feel like they're just rolling through, using some different options, trying to be focused. Ekholm and Carrier have been playing so well together, it's kind of easy to put them back together.
And that's what they'll go with here. Face off for Sissons against Philip Deneau.
You know Josi and Ekholm are going to get a ton of minutes.
Arvidsson off the draw, tried to pull the trigger. Now Doughty shoots, just wide off the backboard. Boxing out hard was Carrier. Kept his man off of the rebound. Now it's a fight for the puck in the corner. It's wedged with 3:04 to go. Quick staying put for the moment.
good zone shrink. All five guys in the defensive zone, shrinking around the puck, getting a stop and getting it clear. That's big.
Sissons cleared it. Dowdy chased by Trennan. Trennan lost his balance. Janot came in to try to get it. Now they've got to hustle back. Passes ahead for Moore. He juggled it at the line. Plays offside. 2:41 to go on the clock.
Now this is what I was talking about. As soon as you get a stop in the defensive zone, no plays are going to be made. So you want to flood the zone. You want to flood that area. Make sure that you outnumber their guys. And you'll go ahead and battle there as long as you want. As long as you can't make a play when you get out, eventually you get possession and you get the clear. But that's, John Hines talks about that all the time. The five-man unit, support each other, get the stops on the boards and help each other get the puck out.
Benning with Yossi again on the blue line. And it's Ryan Johansson's line. Holvin first there in the offensive zone with Luke Cunning. Johansson sent it off the back of the cage. 2:24 to go. Kings with possession. A long stretch pass. Yossi wins the race for icing. 45 shots for the Kings.
Yeah, that's a lot of work for Juice. You know what, though? I talked to him earlier in the year, and I said, how do you feel about playing the lion's share of the games? You're the guy now. You're the go-to. And he did. He's awesome. Just I love playing hockey. I'll go play any chance I get. What do you mean? Let me out there. Well, he's got his work tonight.
Asheville with Forsberg somehow coming up with possession there. He had Grandin wide open. Kopitar against Yossi. A pair of captains. A one-timer by Kempe. And it slips past the line.
Now, Kopitar just put it right on a platter for him. Go ahead. Take a bite of this.
Jonathan Quick is headed for the bench. It is a 6-on-5. The extra attacker is on. Forsberg trying to clear it up the wall. Forsberg a second chance. Forsberg got it across the line. Trying to wrestle it free. Duchesne from the red line. Tried to pull the trigger and he missed it wide. But no icing. The clock will keep moving.
It looked like his stick broke. It didn't. It just kind of flubbed off the end.
Missed opportunity there. Around the boards now. Predators were in this position a lot two nights ago in Vegas and survived somehow. Now they'll be backs against the wall again.
Is that shrink? Knock it out there. Leave it there.
It comes away. Nashville pushes it ahead. Trennan, he's got Janot with him. Trennan tries to push it deep. Kopitar trying to fend him off. Janot to Trennan. They score!
That's what you wanted, Big Bill, huh?
The big fellas, Trennan and Janot. They just muscled it all the way down and put this game away.
Well, that all started in the defensive zone and then just get it up there and I'll keep hacking and whacking. Nice feed there. You know, Trennan does all that work to get it deep, but Janot knows exactly what he's going to do with it when he gets it. Just a quick behind the back pass. He knows he's there. And Trennan ices it.
Trennan with goals in back-to-back games, his eighth of the year. He's got 8 goals in the last 22 games. Now the Kings have to be super urgent. Quick looking at going to the bench. He's going to wait for a minute. But they're going to go for it here. Why not? They've been no shortage of chances. Under a minute to go. Nashville getting the empty net goal to get the cushion to 2. On the boards it comes. Ekholm trying to clear it. Matt Roy kicked it, and it was a save made by Riddick.
Did it hit him right in the head?
Hit him right in the noggin. There he is. Get the ice bag. I think he's okay, though. Let's watch this.
That's bizarre. Just a quick, funny bounce, and Roy just a little soccer kick. It's a good save. Look at him rubbing his head. No blood, you're good. Kings are going to take a timeout here. And
so the Kings have not given up the fort here. Yeah, they
need a quick
fight here.
Juice, you deserve a break. Go over and sit by the bench.
UC Saros had a season-high 41 saves on Tuesday. Tonight, he's got 43, and he may have to make a couple of more.
Yeah, he's been spectacular. He was spectacular in Vegas. He's spectacular tonight. You know you don't want to have to rely on your goalie all the time, but it's nice to have him back there, isn't it? I mean, that's...
Well, he has answered any question that anybody had about what he was doing towards the end of the season, where he carried the team down the stretch.
Yeah.
In the first year that he was really the unquestioned starter from the start of the year. It was only a 56-game season. There were those that said, well, let me see if you can do it in an 82-game
season. That wasn't a blip on the screen. That's the real deal. This guy's legit. You talk to any of the players, and they'll tell you it's tough to score on him in practice and obviously tough to score on him in games.
His 28th start of the season. That is tied for the most in the NHL. 40.9 to go. Another faceoff win for the Kings. Doughty playing catch Kopitar. It's still a 6-on-5. There's a shot in front. Arvidsson, the rebound, and it's sent wide. Saros makes another big save. Arvidsson has been all over the net front. Kopitar winds it around. Doughty looks forward again. Burke lets it go. Another save for Saros. The rebound all the way back out to the point.
Juice is trying to make his own clears now.
Kempe. Kempe a second time. Block shot for Vietzky. Steers it. 3 seconds to go. Puck cleared to the line. Burke at the buzzer. And that will do it. UC Saros, 46 saves, a season high. And the Predators, for the second straight game on this Western swing, have relied on number 74 to hold off a furious rally.
Whew. White-knuckled all the way down to the end, and a couple more chances. Juice stood on his head right to the end, and I was impressed with a great Kings effort, and Fred's able to hold him off.
So the Predators, with a pair of power play goals plus a goal from the former King, Matt Luff, get just enough offense. The empty net goal by Trennan put it away, and Nashville is able to win it 4-2. Stick around for Predators Live, presented by Farm Bureau Health Plans. That's coming up next on Valley Sports.